Hey guys, Vikas over here and this is VR Genius. Guys, today I am with a new video around Orange 5.0. We will see how to install Ubuntu OS on it. So over here, we will see how to download the OS, prepare the SD card and configure a static IP. So guys, being said that, let's get started. So guys, to start with, let's first download the Orange 5.0 OS and we are going to use Ubuntu. So to do that, just search for Orange 5.0 OS and go ahead with Orange 5 downloads. And on second, you can find Ubuntu desktop. Click on this. Then there are two links to download the OS, but the Google Drive link is not working. So go ahead with Baidu Cloud. But downloading from this Baidu Cloud is a tedious process. To make it easy, you can use a Chrome add-on that is Temper Monkey. So go ahead and search for Temper Monkey Chrome add-on. And this lets you run some scripts which will help you to download from Baidu Cloud. So go to Temper Monkey Chrome Web Store and over here you can click Add to Chrome. As I have already installed, it is showing me Added to Chrome. Now to get the downloading script for Baidu, you can search for Baidu Temper Monkey download script and this is by TD423. Go with that and you can simply click install over here. As I have already installed, it is showing me reinstall version this. So after that, whenever you open your Baidu Cloud having some files or something, we'll see on your Chrome taskbar or address bar something like this, Temper Monkey with one running file but which is not shown in other tabs. So that means you can download it with it. So now click on this download button and your download should start in a sec. Now after the download finishes, you'll get a file something like this. Now it's time to extract it. Go ahead, extract here and open up any software that you are using for disk imaging. So over here I am using Win32 disk imager that works fine for IMG files and all. Can use any software that is supporting .img file or disk images. But before writing the OS into flash drive, make sure your flash drive is empty. And if you are having already some OS onto it, you can format it by using the software ST formatter, for which I have given the link down below in the description. You can download it. And let's go ahead with formatting and select your drive you want to format. And over here it will show you the size currently it is available. So as it is fully formatted, it is showing me the total available space. And make sure you are selecting the correct drive because it will wipe out all those data. So click on format, click on OK. Now you will get all the available space or full space of or full capacity of the drive. So click on this, click on exit. And over here I am using Win32, so let's open it up. Select the disk image or draw IMG file. Yeah, you can see over here Ubuntu desktop for Orange 5.0 with version number and all. Click on open, select the flash drive. And make sure again you are selecting the correct drive, then click on write, click on yes. And this might take some time to write the OS onto the flash drive. Now after the write completes, it will show you message like write successful. Click on OK, click on exit and remove your SD card, plug it into your Orange Pi Zero and let's get into the monitor and we'll see the booting and all.
So guys, we are going to use the video out of this Orange Pi Zero module for display, as this board doesn't have any HDMI output. So to connect that, we are going to need a simple cable like this, which has two port connectors at one end and the video or RCA input at another. Then you just need to connect these two pins to ground and TV out of Orange Pi Zero, and these GPIOs over here provide you USB out, microphone in, infrared in and TV out as well as audio out. So you can simply take out the TV out pin over here, TV out pin from this GPIO, and you can connect it to any video input device or any like TV tuner or simply to a TV directly. So to make the connections, we just need ground pin, that is second pin from USB side, and we need to connect the video out, that is the fifth pin. And of course you can check out the pin diagram for this to make sure to connect properly. And that's all with this. So let's power it on and we'll check out on display.
So guys, over here I have connected my Orange Pi Zero to this monitor and it is booting right now. And unlike Raspberry Pi, you can't find any boot logs and all onto the screen. Straight away it brings the login screen, and the default password and username for login is Orange Pi only. And after logging in, you can find the LXDE, that is desktop environment for the Lubuntu. And over here on the window or the main screen, you will find FRAS and some sample audio file, that is some staudio.wav, and you will find the LXDE Windows environment. So let's get back to PC and we'll try to have a SSH connection. Now connecting the Orange Pi Zero with an Ethernet cable to our local network. As the Orange Pi Zero is in currently DHCP mode by default, we can find out the IP address of the Orange Pi Zero by using utility like nmap. So over here I am using a tool genmap, and it will let me find out the IP address of the Orange Pi Zero, because that is again in DHCP mode, so we are unaware of IP address taken by the Orange Pi Zero. Or if you are having a router or something, you can check out the DHCP table of your router to find out the IP address of the Orange Pi Zero. As the IP address is must to access the Orange Pi Zero from a different PC by using SSH or using the FTP to upload files and all. So to do that, I can use the command nmap -sn, then the IP address base, then the TTL time. And over here you can see all these devices. This is my Netgear router, my Lappy, this is my desktop. The only one unknown IP is these two, but 107 is my mobile phone IP, the hotspot IP. So this one seems to be the Orange Pi Zero IP, and it is showing MAC address something like 6297D7732F5. So let's check out by logging in into using WinSCP. So open up WinSCP, type in the IP .0.2, then use the username Orange Pi, password Orange Pi. Let's hope it works. I think I mistyped the password. Anyway, here comes the interface Over here you can see the files present in OrangePie. So as you saw earlier in desktop you have got only one file, that testaudio.wav file, nothing else. Now let's open up PuTTY to access terminal. Okay, now you can see it is giving a warning that sudo fs resize to resize file system. As in case Raspbian JC installation, the file system is automatically resized, but over here it is not happening, so we have to do it manually by using this command provided over here. So let's do that, sudo fs resize, go ahead with password. Yeah, the root fs is extended. Now I can reboot by using the command sudo reboot. Yeah, it's getting rebooted. I hope it takes the same IP address as earlier, otherwise we have to search it again and find out the IP to log in again. Hope it has taken the same IP. Yeah. Okay, let's open up terminal again. Okay, it has successfully resized the FS or file system. And now to update it to the latest version, we need internet connection on this OrangePie. But as my network doesn't provide internet connection on DHCP links, I need to have a static IP on OrangePie 0. So to set up a static IP, we can use the command sudo nano slash etc slash network slash interfaces, provide the password, and over here I can write something like auto eds0, or you can check the interface first. That is using WF config, and for Ethernet you can see the interface is ETH0. And it's not showing up the WLAN connection. Anyway, let's try out to make a static IP. Auto ETH0. I face ETH0 INET static IP. It takes different parameters like ADD, RS address, advanced state, 0 dot. Let's say I provide it 5, then network. Then netmask, then gateway. So if you are configuring your static IP, make sure you have all this information. Now press Ctrl X then Y to save it. Now one more thing we need to change is sudo nano the DNS address, that is using the command and over here I'll have my DNS server address. Yeah, now to make it to make the changes effective, we need to restart the interface, or we can go ahead with reboot. Let's check. We are able to ping the provided IP address. Yeah, you can see we are able to ping the IP address. That means the Orange Pi has successfully taken up the IP address. Now again, we can provide the new IP. Click on yes. Now again, open up terminal. Click on yes, no issue. And let's check, we have internet connection. So for the time being, let's update the OS right now. Sudo apt get update. And it may take some time depending upon your internet connectivity. And to upgrade, let's use the command sudo apt-get create again. Again, it might time. Again, it might need time. It is now asking to download this much of packages. Go ahead, click with Y. So guys, it seems everything is installed. We are good to use the AllSpice Zero with Lubuntu. So that's all for today guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching. So I'll publish more videos around Java application development and like VNC installation and all those things on AllSpice Zero in my upcoming videos. And if you have liked this video, you can hit the thumbs up button. And if you have not subscribed yet, you can definitely subscribe to my channel for latest updates. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.